Thank you for seeing my videos, thank you for subscribing to my channel, and today I'm trying to fit this cooler to my computer. So if you want, put like, if you want, put dislike. Don't forget that I have affiliate links on the description of the video. Leave a comment, no, leave a comment, and I will see you soon when I'm trying to put this cooler. Thank you for seeing my videos, thank you for subscribing to my channel, and today I'm not only going to try and fit in a cooler for the CPU, but also to change the CPU to this one. It's an i7. I'm going to put everything on the description from the i5 that I have. The first one is not to unscrew, but to take the battery out, as you are taking in your computer also the electricity out, so you're not going to short anything there. So I'm going to unscrew those two screws. There are those two screws that are far from me, relative where you are seeing that, and I'm going to unscrew them in order to take the plastic cover that is covering the CPU and all the internals and the motherboard and everything that I need to touch in order to take the CPU out. So taking this cover out, and also zooming in order to show you better which screws you need to take out. Well, as you can see right now, those are the four screws, 1 and 2, and those and the other two on the other side, you need to take them out. Well, you need to unscrew them, not to take them out. If not, you're going to do something wrong to the computer. And those are the four screws that you need to unscrew. Also, don't forget to take the cable to disconnect it from this connector. As you can see, the connector is in the right side of the screen where I'm taking out the tape. And there is the connector, and I need to take it out, so I'm not going to it and cut it. So there are another two screws, as you can see on the far side of the computer. They are almost on the fan, a little bit behind the fan or before the fan, depends how you are seeing that, and you need to take them out, unscrew them, and to take them out, so you're going to unscrew them. And this is the fan, and as you can see, there is no much paste there, and also the cooler for the CPU. In order to clean the CPU, as you know already, or you're not knowing, you can use ethanol or propanol, 70% and above. As more as purer, it's better, because it's not going to have much water, it's going to have more ethanol or propanol. Well, as you can see, this is the CPU. It's without the cooler, without the fan, and only thermal paste from 2014. As you can see, it's reading also on the chassis. This is the the date that the computer passed its quality check. So cleaning the CPU. I need to clean the CPU so I can storage and sell it if I want. I don't want to sell a dirty CPU, because, well, it doesn't look right. Well, to me, it doesn't look right. And in order to take the CPU from the socket, what you need is a Torx screw head. As you can see, I am trying to find the right one. You need to find the right one before that you are changing the CPU. Not like me, that after changing or after taking the cooler from the CPU, I'm trying to see which one is going to be a match with this type of Torx or this type of screw. This is very unprofessional of me to do it after I took all the cooler from the CPU, and I needed to do that just before of that. As you can see, I'm trying every other thing which is not working, but you will find it at the end. So now I found it, and I need to move it anti-clockwise in order to unclock the CPU socket and take the CPU out. As you can see, this is the CPU, this is the i5 which came with this computer, and I bought it used with the computer, not the CPU, CPU 2. This is also a new CPU, this is the i7. As you can see, it's dirty, I need to clean it. And also you can see the triangle, the gold one, is going to match the triangle on the plastic, on the socket, as you see right now. And when it's matched, it's not going to move. In order to lock the CPU, you need to move it clockwise. Well, because unlock was unclockwise, anti-clockwise, sorry. So now cleaning the CPU cooler, so I can put a new thermal paste on the CPU, and also not to leave the old one on this cooler. And also it's going to cool better the CPU. Well, I'm trying to use some type of paste which I had in my possession. The first one, well, it's one of the paste that you are getting with some coolers from other CPUs, and as you're going to see, it's not going to be very good. I hope that it's going to be good, but I don't think that it's going to be very good. It's going to be dry, I think. I think that it dried or something happened with this thermal paste, because, well, it stayed on the plastic and it didn't went out from the plastic which is out housing the thermal paste. And well, I don't know what happened with this thermal paste. Well, everything that is left to do is to put the thermal paste and to close the computer with all the stuff that needs to be closed, like the cooler and the fan and everything that needs to put in place. So putting the thermal paste, this is how much I put of thermal paste. It was only sample that I had with me, so I put everything that it was on the sample. And after that, I need to put the cooler on it. So as you can going to see right now, I'm putting the cooler. At first I needed to adjust the fan, and it was a little bit fight with this fan. I don't know why, but it gave me a little bit of fight in order to put it. It was playing the all the time inside and outside, and in order to put this fan. But after a while I was able to put the fan, although this is the fan that came with this computer. I don't know why it's giving me so much of fight. So as you can see, the fan is in, the cooler is in, and now I'm going to put the cable first, and after that I'm going to screw everything in order to prepare it to close everything. So also this tape needs to be a tape, well, needs to hold the cable, so it's not going to be free. And also those screws that I take at the first time before I took the CPU out, I need to screw them in, but on this time I didn't screw them in, I screwed them somewhere in, and now I'm going to screw them in as it's supposed to be. Be careful when you're doing that and you are not doing like I did, because it can do some damage to your motherboard or CPU if you're not careful. So screwing it in, always this X method. The X method is going to spread the pressure evenly on the CPU, on this CPU, especially because the die is exposed and there is no casing on the die which is going to protect the die. So please be careful, because those CPUs, they are hard to find right now and they are also expensive, very expensive. Even if you buy them on eBay, they are going to be very expensive. Well, after closing those four screws, there are those two screws on the fan that I screw in, and now putting this cover, the plastic cover, and screwing the two other screws in, which are going to also hold this cover. Just one thing you need to take in mind: the i5 is going to be use a 65 watt charger, and the i7 is going to use a 90 watt charger, and you need to buy the 90 watt charger in order to use the computer with the charger. If not, you're going to be use only the battery. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you like the video, like the video. If you dislike the video, dislike the video. Leave a comment. See my links in the description of this video, and have a good life. Good life.